We are gearing up for this dramatic setting here, Pyeongchang, South Korea. We will be there, get things underway February 8th at the Olympics. And of course, Nathan Chen will be there and will be, if not the favorite, one of the favorites. He won his second straight U.S. title here in San Jose this week. Vincent Joe skated to the bronze medal. He's only 17 years old, calls this area home, and he'll be going, as will Adam Rippon. He struggled in his free skate. However, with the body of work over the last year or so, he was named to the U.S. Olympic team, and they do offer a pewter medal, so four men on the podium at the national championships. Ross Miner was great. He will not be heading to Pyeongchang. We first took notice of Nathan Chen at the gala in 2010. He talked to Andrea Joyce then and offered a very bold prediction.
Which Olympics are we going to see you in?
2018, I think.
And guess what? He's going to be there. Right now, he is backstage along with Vincent Joe and Adam Rippon talking to Andrea.
Well, Terry, clearly we are never going to let Nathan forget that moment from 2010. But what is this like for you all of these years later to have this moment finally be here and to be able to live up to that prediction?
Honestly, this is so incredible and truly a dream come true.
So this was a wild night. I mean, I don't think that anybody could have ever written a script for this. Vincent, a dramatic rise from fifth place up to third for you. You get on the podium, but no guarantee that you're going to get a spot. What was last night like? What was the wait like? Can you describe it?
The wait was, the apprehension was, it was crazy. Everyone was at the edge of their seats, and I didn't know what was going to happen. Nobody knew what was going to happen. Everybody was throwing predictions left and right. It was definitely an amazing. Crazy.
I mean, were you
amazing.
Pacing? What were you doing? How were you killing the time?
I was just sitting on my bed and just like, you know, just waiting for it to happen.
Adam.
Andrea.
You have always talked about how much you love drama, but I'm thinking even for you, that might have been a little bit too much last night.
It was way too much drama, even for me. Last night was crazy. You know, going into this competition, I knew what the criteria was to make the Olympic team. I've been to two Grand Prix finals. I've medaled at the last four Grand Prix events I've done. I'm a former U.S. champion. And so I just wanted to come here and skate really well. And I'm really proud of the short program I did. And then just right at the end, I just made some really stupid errors.
So when you're waiting and you get that text, take me back to that moment when you found out that you were selected for the team. What happened?
You know, before I was selected for the team, I was sitting in my room with Derek Delmore, one of my coaches, my mom, and Ashley Wagner. And Ashley Wagner kind of felt like she was in this same, like, identical situation 4 years ago. And, you know, I was at peace with whatever the selection committee would make, but then I got that text, and it's just, I think that's when it really hit me, like, my Olympic dream is going to be realized.
So, Nathan, you're the only one who was resting easy. You were the only sure bet last night. Aside from family and friends, who else did you hear from? Anybody exciting?
Actually, the Utah Jazz tweeted at me, congratulating me like a fellow Utahan, so that was really, really cool. And yeah, everything else was just family and friends, and it was a really nice night.
So it wasn't just that you won. I mean, it was the way that you won. You know, you had a rough week being sick with all of the pressure. What does it do for you as you get ready for Pyeongchang? How does it set you up?
This definitely builds my confidence, you know, especially knowing that I didn't have necessarily the greatest week of training, but still came here and got the job done, so... You know, I know I'm capable of doing that, and, you know, just got to make sure that I keep my mind straight and, you know, go to the games excited.
And Vincent, you kind of struggled this season on the Grand Prix, and you came back, you had a comeback from fifth place. What was it that made the difference for you out there?
The training that I've had leading up to this competition. The training was different from my training before the Grand Prix, and it was very effective, and it showed.
Okay, big age difference here. You're going to have to be the team dad.
I am.
All right.
I'm team dad. And these are my two sons. I'm so proud of them. I'm doing such a great job as
a parent.
Good
luck, guys. Yeah. All right. And we will be back with much more in San Jose as we continue with the free dance in a moment. Congratulations again, guys.